eldest of Sussex have the son Archie Harrison in 2019 and currently live together in California. The Wright family is yet to issue a statement on the nudes, and it's unclear if other members of the family were aware out of the ordinary. He tests positive for the coronavirus, and within weeks, he, like hundreds of thousands of others, has died. And she wrote, "In places where there was once community, there is now division. We aren't just fighting over opinions or facts, we are joined." She wrote, "It was a July morning that began as ordinarily as any other day. Make breakfast, feed the dogs, take vitamins, find that missing shock, pick up the roof, carry on that road of the lost priority this morning." In her article, Duchess of Sussex reflects on the struggle that has been 2020, noting that loss and pain that has left many people have lost loved ones to virus and the civil unrest that took place in America earlier this year. She wrote, "We've heard all the stories. A woman starts her day as normal as all the other, but then receives a call that she's lost her elderly mother to COVID-19. A man wakes feeling fine, maybe a little sluggish, but nothing. Go under the table, throw my hair in my ponytail before getting my son from his crib. After changing his diaper, I felt sharp cramp. I dropped to the floor with him in my arms and humming a lullaby to keep us both calm. Meghan Markle miscarriage. When did Duchess of Sussex suffer tragic loss? The Duchess of Sussex has revealed she has a miscarriage. Meghan Markle revealed the tragic news in an article in the New York Times today. She and Prince Harry, who have been married since 2018, already have one son, Archie, born in 2019. Meghan made the heartbreaking admission in an opinion article for the American News Polaris over whether the fact is, in fact, a fact. We're at odds over whether science is real. We're at odds over whether an election has been won or lost. We're at odds over the value of compromise. Meghan wrote about how sharing her loss could help her and other women come to terms with their grief. She wrote, "Losing a child means carrying an almost unbearable grief, experienced by many but talked about by few. In the pain of our loss, my husband and I discovered that in a room of 100 women, 10 to 20 of them will have suffered from a miscarriage. Yet despite the staggering commonality of this pain, the conversation remains taboo, riddled with unwarranted shame and perpetuating a cycle of solitary mourning. Arm and kiss his cockles wet from both our tears. Staring at the cold white walls, my eyes glaze over. I try to imagine how we could heal. The Duke and Duchess, the cheerful tone of stark contrast to my sense that something was not right. I knew as I clutched my firstborn child that was I losing my second. Hours later, I lay in the hospital bed, holding my husband's hands. I felt the clamminess of his paw.